Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all well and having a lovely, lovely day. So today I'm going to be talking to you guys about my experience volunteering abroad, and I'm also going to be giving you guys some tips if you're thinking of volunteering abroad or if you know that you're already going to volunteer abroad. So without further ado, let's just get into it. So I'm firstly going to start off by talking about my experience volunteering abroad. So if you're kind of new to my channels and haven't been following me for very long, you won't know that I volunteered abroad. So I've actually volunteered abroad twice. The first time I went to Peru, and that was in January 2017 to April 2017. So I volunteered there for 3 months. And then the second time that I volunteered abroad was in Morocco, and I went in August 2017 to October 2017. So I was there for 2 months. And I did both of those volunteering trips with the same volunteering organization, and that was Original Volunteers. So in a couple of messages that I've got from you guys, you've been saying that you haven't read good reviews on Original Volunteers, and so you're a bit confused as to why, like, I went again with them and why I really liked them. I want to firstly start off by saying that my review on them isn't like gonna certify that your experience with them is gonna be amazing. I feel like every project differs and everybody's experience differs, but I'm just going to tell you about my experience with them and how I really, really liked them as a company. So before I went to Peru, I was really nervous. I'd never been abroad. I was really scared about like getting 3 flights there on my own when I'd only ever flown with my dad once to London, so like I had no idea what to expect. And I was also just really nervous about being away from home for so long, because the most I've ever been away from home is like when I went on a school trip for a week to Edinburgh or something like that. And so I just didn't know what to expect about being away from home for 3 months, like being on the other side of the world, like my first time abroad. I'm going to South America. This is quite a big deal, and I was like 18, so my parents were really worried and stuff and really wanted to know more about it as well. So what I really liked about Original Volunteers before I actually went abroad was that their website is so good, and there's also so much information on there about each of the projects. It tells you like what a typical week will be like, where you'll be staying, like how you'll get there. It gives you advice on like vaccinations, anything that you're worrying about, it gives you advice on. And it's really good for parents as well. They have a section for parents to read up on. It gives you ideas of things you can do once you get there in your spare time. It lets you know what you should be taking with you, things you should pack. It has reviews from other volunteers on there and things that they would recommend you take with you, or things they recommend that you do before going. So basically on that website, everything is explained so well and so clearly, and it makes the whole process so much less daunting. I also found it so useful that you could email Original Volunteers whenever you wanted. So I would actually email them quite often before I went away on a trip, because I'm such a worrier. And so I'd be like, hey, do you think it would be a good idea to take this? Or I'm a bit confused about what injections I need, da 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 da. And I would email them all the time. I was so surprised they weren't fed up with me, but honestly, they were so quick at replying. Like, they would email me either that day or the day after. It was so good, and they would always provide really helpful information and like give me links to different parts of their website that I could read up on, and I really found it so useful. Another great thing about Original Volunteers is the travel buddy list. So if you want to volunteer but you're a bit nervous about going out there on your own, there's like a buddy list that you can sign yourself up to, and so you can get talking to other volunteers, get to know them and find out who's going to be going when you're going. Or if you haven't booked your flights yet, then you can book your flights with them. So if you don't want to travel alone, then you can get a flight together with someone else, which is a really good idea. So yeah, all in all, I can't fault Original Volunteers before I left the UK. I thought they were really, really helpful and answered any of my questions and made me feel a lot more at ease about going and volunteering abroad. So let's start off with my volunteering experience in Peru. So once I got there, I was very nervous because I had obviously just landed in this foreign airport, and I was told that someone from Original Volunteers was going to pick me up. So the project coordinator was actually late, and I was so scared because loads of men were like coming over to me and just like asking me if I wanted a taxi and stuff, and I was like no, but they wouldn't leave me alone, so I was like really panicking. And then a guy like tried to take my luggage and I was like, no, give me my luggage. And then he asked me for money and then wouldn't leave me alone until I gave him money. So when I landed in Peru, I thought, what the heck have I got myself into? This is not a legit like company. They haven't come to pick me up. I was like, goodness knows what is gonna happen to me. I'm so afraid and I just wanted to go home. But the project coordinator luckily came to pick me up and he was really apologetic and he was super nice. And there had been a mix up with my pickup. I don't know what happened there. So I was quite disappointed with that and I'd hoped that there would have been like a quicker, more efficient pickup, like it would have been on time and that I wouldn't have been left standing feeling really scared and alone in a foreign country. So the project coordinator was so nice and he was really chatty on the like car journey to the volunteer house. So he was super, super friendly. I really liked him. And then he showed me to my room. I feel like with the Peru project, the coordinator could have been there more. I feel like their help and support was better before I left the UK, but when I got to Peru, it wasn't as great. I still really enjoyed the experience, but I feel like I had to do most of it on my own. What I mean by that is the project coordinator literally left me in my room and I was like, what on earth do I do? Like, I'm so confused. He didn't tell me where I can go to buy water. He didn't tell me where I could go to buy food. He didn't even tell me, like, can I just go down to the orphanage and volunteer whenever, or is there set hours? He didn't introduce me to any of the other volunteers. He really just left me and told me nothing. He didn't give me a number to, like, contact him or anything. So I kind of had to figure things out for myself. And luckily, I just kind of, like, plucked up the courage to go down to the orphanage. And then I kind of just introduced myself to other volunteers. And luckily, like, they helped me. But if it weren't for the other volunteers, I feel like I wouldn't have known what I was doing, so I feel like the project coordinator could have been more involved. He wasn't really ever at the orphanage, so it was really hard to like get hold of him, and eventually when I did like get his contact details, he was not very good at replying and stuff like that. But he was a really nice guy, but I just feel like he wasn't there as much because he was so busy. But I feel like original volunteers should have more like project coordinators, if that's the case, so that there's always someone there. So you might be thinking, like, why am I saying original volunteers is good if I'm like kind of got a lot of negative things to say? But I just feel like I had the greatest experience of my life. Like, everything that I wanted to do, I got to do, and I was just looking for somewhere that I could help, that I would feel good about myself for doing something good in the world, for helping those who are less fortunate, and that's exactly what I got to do. But I'm just saying that there could be some slight changes made so that the volunteers are able to get that help and support that they get in the UK when they get to Peru as well. I thoroughly enjoyed volunteering in the girls' orphanage in Peru every single day for 3 months. It was the best experience of my life. I got to know the kids so well and build up such a lovely relationship with them, and they were all so grateful for everything. Like, I brought a lot of things for them in my suitcase and they just were so happy every time I brought out like a colouring book or something for them. It was just so lovely to see, and honestly just made my day, like making them happy. And it was so nice for them to have that affection and attention that they really deserve, because the orphanage that I worked in, there was only one woman who actually like lived there, and she looked after all the kids, but she had to cook and clean, and that's what she did most of the day. So she was such a hard worker, and so she never really got time to spend with the children, and it was so nice for us volunteers to do that. So when you volunteer abroad, you often get like the weekend off to explore the country. So I did some awesome things, like go to Machu Picchu. Like, I hiked that, it was incredible. I hiked the Rainbow Mountain, and it was just so nice to explore the country as well as volunteering and working. It was such a nice balance. I would also just like to say, I got really ill when I was in Peru. It was on the way back from Rainbow Mountain. I was just like vomiting everywhere and like had really bad diarrhea, and I felt so weak. Like, I was hanging out of the minibus window, and we had like an 8-hour drive back from Rainbow Mountain, and it was like these windy, horrible roads, and it was just disgusting. I thought it was like altitude sickness, because Rainbow Mountain is like 5,000 meters above sea level, I think. So yeah, I was hanging out the window just vomiting, and when I got back to the volunteer apartment, I was like that for 2 days. I literally couldn't get out of bed. Every time I tried to step out of bed, I would fall. It was like I was so faint and like my head just hurt to just lift my head up off my pillow. I couldn't like keep water down. It was so horrible. It was the worst pain ever. I was literally crying and rolling around in bed for like 2 days, just like stabbing pains in my stomach and constantly vomiting and falling over. It was so horrible. The reason that I wanted to add this in this video is because if you're thinking of volunteering abroad and you're a bit like scared about what will happen if you get ill abroad, if you go with original volunteers, I will say you do not have to worry. They took such good care of me. The project coordinator actually phoned an ambulance for me because he was really worried about me, and he came with me to the hospital in the ambulance, and it was just so lovely of him to do that. He took such great care of me. So obviously I was absolutely terrified about being abroad for the first time and also being in hospital for the first time. I actually like was terrified. I remember just crying and just being like, I wanted my mum. But I was so glad to be in like safe hands and to know that I was actually going to get better, because like honestly, I'm not even over exaggerating, I thought I was dying and I just wanted my mum, because like I just didn't know what was wrong with me. So it turned out I had a parasite and I had to stay in hospital for 2 days. But honestly, I don't know what I would have done without my project coordinator. I'm so thankful and grateful that he took me to that hospital and that I got better. Moving on to volunteering in Morocco, it was a much more like smoother experience. I don't know if it was because it was my second time, but as soon as I landed in Marrakesh airport, the taxi driver for original volunteers came to pick me up. He was on time. He took me to the volunteer house, and then I was met by the project coordinator. He showed me where to get water, where to get like toilet paper, where to eat and stuff, and it was just so much more smoother. And what I also liked about the Marrakesh project in Morocco was that everything was done as a group, whereas when I was in Peru, everything like you did by yourself. Like you went out to the shop by yourself, you went out to eat by yourself, unless like you made friends with other volunteers. But the Peru project was actually quite quiet, and so at times I was like one of three or four volunteers, and so we kind of just did our separate things and like we'd go down to volunteer with the children at different times. Whereas in Morocco, you all go out to your projects together each day at certain times, and it was so much more organized. I really liked it. There was like a schedule every day of what you were going to be doing. So yeah, I really liked that. We went out together, we came back together, and quite often we ate out together as well. We went out to get food and stuff. So it was so much more organized, and it was a real like group project. You all worked together, and I really liked that. I will say the Marrakesh Morocco project with original volunteers, if you're thinking of doing it, it's a really popular project. So I went from like in Peru when there was only like three or four volunteers at a time to in Marrakesh where I was living in a house with like 25 other volunteers. So it was like pretty like difficult experience for me because of like my social anxiety, but I feel like really proud that I did it and that I managed to do it. It was tough at times, but I made some really great friends when I was there, which really helped me through that. The thing I really loved about the Morocco volunteering project was the wider variety of volunteering options there was. I really enjoyed like in Peru where I was volunteering in the girls' orphanage like every day because I got to know them better and get a better relationship with them. But I also really enjoyed visiting different places in Morocco. Like there was different like villages that we would visit, there was different orphanages, different nurseries, different special needs centres, different like Down syndrome schools. There was so much more, but both were such incredible experiences that I learned so much from, that I gained so much confidence from, and that I will remember forever. Honestly, I just feel so lucky that I've been able to volunteer abroad and help children. And like, even when I look back at the pictures from those trips, I just like cry because I'm like, oh my gosh, those were such incredible experiences and memories that I will treasure forever. Those kids will always have a special place in my heart. What was also completely different about the Morocco project was that there was always a project coordinator there, like actually living with you, which I really liked. So it made me feel like so much more at ease and at rest, that if I had any like worries or problems or just like any questions, or if I needed to know like where to go to get something, I could literally just go upstairs and there would be a coordinator there who could help me. And there was also like more than one coordinator, which was really good, which I would have preferred to be the same in Peru. And also you got the weekends off, so you would volunteer usually like Monday to Friday, and then the weekends would be your free time so you could do whatever you wanted. Again, I will say much more organized. In Peru, you had to do everything yourself, so you would have to actually go into the center of Cusco, which is the city that I volunteered in. And then once you were in the center, you'd have to go around looking for deals and stuff and try and get the best one. And the problem with that was not a lot of people there spoke English, and so it was really, really difficult. But in Morocco, you literally just said to your project coordinator, hey, I want to go to the Sahara Desert, and he'd be like, great, I'll organize that for you. You leave at this time on Saturday morning. It was perfect. Like, it was so easy. Like, you had to do nothing, and there was a set price, whereas in Peru, you had to kind of look around for the best price. And in Morocco, your coordinator would be like, yeah, it's that price for every single volunteer. We organize everything for you, get the taxi for you, da 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 da, everything is done. It was so good. So yeah, I went to the Sahara Desert, which was incredible. I got up to so much there. I feel like I'm rambling so much about my experience volunteering abroad, so I'm just gonna wrap this part of the video up by telling you guys that I actually filmed a Peru video and a Morocco video. If you are thinking of volunteering abroad and you kind of want to see what like the everyday life looks like when you're volunteering abroad, then I would definitely recommend that you go and check those out. I will leave both of them linked down below. So moving on to my tips for volunteering abroad, the first one would definitely be to be organized before you go. So what I mean by that is do your research. If you're traveling with original volunteers or like another volunteering company or organization, go on their like website, read up on like their tips and look at their like packing lists and things that you need to have done before you go. I actually have a packing video on this channel from my trip to Morocco. I didn't film one for Peru, but if you're volunteering abroad and you're not sure what to take, I will leave my video linked down below. I packed a lot for the children and wanted to like bring as much as possible over to them. Obviously you don't need to bring that much, but I just wanted to, and of course like I was staying for quite a long time. If you want an idea of what sort of things to bring for the children, then definitely check that video out as well. Another tip is definitely not to overpack. Pack as little for you as possible so that you can bring more for the children. That's definitely what I did. My whole suitcase was filled with toys and crafts for the children, and then I had my little like carry-on backpack that had my clothes in it. You can always wash your clothes when you're out there, which is what I did. Just remember that you're there to volunteer and that it doesn't really matter what you look like. So with original volunteers, you have to pay a registration fee of £125. So you have 12 months of volunteering that you can do without having to pay a registration fee again. And then the weekly cost of the projects all differ. So definitely just go onto the original volunteers website to find out what like projects they do and how much they cost. I think the Peru project that I did was £125 a week, and that's for like the accommodation only. You then have to pay £10 for a airport transfer, and then you have to like pay for your own food and drink and like toiletries and stuff like that. You have to pay for yourself. I think there are some projects that you get food included or that you have to pay some money for each day or week or something. I'm not sure, but just go onto the website, it will be able to tell you. As far as I can remember, the Morocco project was also £125 per week, and then also like the £10 airport transfer, and again it was like pay for your own food and pay for anything else yourself that you're going to need out there. I can't remember exactly how much I spent over there, but I feel like for everyone, again, it's going to differ. If you have a bigger budget and you want to like eat out every night, then it's going to cost you obviously a bit more. But if you're like me and want to kind of save a bit of money, I tended to like eat in quite a lot, and then like maybe once or twice a week I would go out for like dinner. So it's definitely not expensive to live over in foreign countries. For example, when I was in Morocco, you could get your breakfast for like less than 50p a day, like your lunch would be about £1 a day, and your dinner would be about £3. So roughly like £5 a day if you're gonna like want to eat out. But if you want to be like cheap like me, then you can get away with a lot less than that. Also, I will add, if you want to do like excursions and stuff, that's obviously going to cost a bit more, but again, you can go onto their website and they have prices of how much like the Sahara Desert will cost, Machu Picchu, Rainbow Mountain, etc, etc. So yeah, just make sure you research how much stuff is going to be and make sure you have enough money, because you don't want to get over there and then realize you can't do all the things that the other volunteers are doing because you haven't like saved enough money or like brought enough money with you. Another tip I would give is like try and learn some of the language. That was something that I didn't do and I really do regret. Bring like a phrase book with you or something, something that will help you get by, because I couldn't really communicate with the children, which you don't really need to, because like children love you even if you can't like speak their language and talk to them. They just really appreciate the things you do for them, and like giving them cuddles and hugs and high fives and stuff, they don't really mind that you can't speak to them. But especially for like the Peru project where there was older children, I definitely wish that I had learned a couple of like phrases and words and stuff so that I could have like spoke to the older girls and got to know them a bit better. But in saying that, you do pick up a little bit here and there, and especially in Peru, the older girls were so like patient with me and helped me learn some words, and I helped them learn English, so it was such a nice thing. I feel like you needed to know Spanish in Peru more than you needed to know Arabic in Morocco, because lots of people in Morocco spoke English. I really feel like that wasn't an issue. But definitely in Peru it was more of an issue where not many people spoke English. Another tip I would give is definitely stay safe. So I think that one of my biggest tips is bring like a bum bag, if you know what I mean, or like a money belt. So when I went to Peru and Morocco, I had a very thin like money belt, so it didn't go over my clothes, it actually went under my clothes and you can't actually see that you're wearing it. So I always put like my cash in there and then I would put it under my clothes, because then if like anyone ever tried to like get into your bag or steal your bag or anything, they don't know that you're wearing a money belt. And so if the worst came to the worst and your stuff got stolen, you still got your valuables, like your money. So yeah, take a money belt and then also like a bum bag as well. I had one of those that I then put over my clothes, and then I would put my valuables, like my bigger valuables, like my phone and my camera. You just have to be very careful and keep an eye on your belongings, and I feel like if they're right there like in front of you, you have a better chance of like keeping them there than if you're wearing a backpack and can't really see what's going on behind you. Someone could easily just take something out of there. Luckily like nothing bad like that happened to me, but it did happen to another volunteer that I was with in Peru, where we were getting on a bus and someone stole her phone, and yeah, she never got it back. So definitely bum bag and money belt. They are absolute essentials and you won't regret buying them. I will try and leave links down below to the ones that I bought or like similar ones, just so you know what I'm talking about. So the most important thing is get involved, make the most of it. I feel like you should go there with such an open mind, a really positive attitude, just wanting to help, to do anything, to get involved with everything and anything that is thrown your way. I definitely did that and I feel like it's the best attitude to go there with. I just wanted to make the most of this experience. It's like a once in a lifetime opportunity. I wanted to help the children as much as possible and give them as much as possible. I loved in Peru when like all the volunteers would put their money together and we'd take the children like out ice skating or like to the fun fair. It was so much fun. And then for example in Peru, when I saw the women who like took care of all the children, who like did all the cleaning and the cooking and everything all day, I would try and help her as much as possible and help her with the dishes and stuff, and just to see her face and her smile was just so, so sweet. And yeah, just get stuck in there. Like honestly, it was so hot in Morocco and I was not used to the heat and I absolutely felt sick some days, but I was still just like play football with the kids and like just get involved even though I felt like I was fainting. But it's just all about that hard work. Like it is hard work. A lot of people think that volunteering abroad is just like a holiday, a sky, but it's really not. You are absolutely exhausted by the end of the day, but if you put so much effort into like making the kids happy and having fun with them, then you will feel so proud of yourself at the end of the day. It's honestly the most rewarding thing ever. And you'll definitely benefit from it so much more. You'll get a lot more from it and learn so much more. And you'll just be like a whole new person. Honestly, volunteering abroad just like changed my life. The kids I met over there, like, oh my gosh, I remember this one little baby that I just had such a bond with. His name was Faisal. I insert a picture here of him. And honestly, he melted my heart. I had such an attachment to him and it was so hard leaving him. I literally just wanted to take him home with me. And then again in Peru, I had this one really strong like bond with this little girl. Her name was Yesenia. And of course you like make bonds with all the children, but I feel like you have those like really special bonds where you just click with a child. And for me, it was Faisal and Yesenia. I'll insert a picture of Yesenia. And she was just so sweet. My last tip is just to have fun and to just make the most of it, because honestly, it passes so quick. I would give anything to go back there again and to see all of those children. Just make the most of it and just enjoy it. Put as much effort in as possible to making these children's lives amazing, to just giving them that happiness and that attention that they deserve. And they honestly have so little, but they're the happiest people in the world, and I feel like I have learned a lot from that. And like coming back home, I feel so much more grateful for everything that I have, even though I was before. I feel like sometimes I could like complain about silly little things, and when you go abroad and see how little everybody else has and just how happy and content they are in their lives and how joyful and like upbeat they always are and how they see the best in everything, it's just so like refreshing to see. So guys, I hope this video has been helpful for you, and that if you're thinking of going abroad to volunteer soon, that you have learnt some useful tips from this video. If you have any more like specific questions about like my experience that you would like me to answer, then please leave them down below. I will definitely make sure I answer them all. Don't forget to check out my videos that I filmed from when I was in Peru and Morocco. I will have them both linked in the description box. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed already. Also, check out my vlogging channel. It's Lucy Lockett Vlogs. It will be linked down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again very, very soon. Bye!